Brian Lowry from the Midland Tribune. Going to give you first hit. Your initial thoughts, KK against St. Rynaghs. We spoke 2 years ago about this final and everyone was kind of 50-50 about it, but it seems a lot of people are favouring KK headed tomorrow.
Yeah, I suppose that 2012 final has been well documented now that it's really been the catalyst for Kilcormac Leahy to kick on. You know, it was amazing things that had never won a county title before that, and to get that one 2012, well, we've all seen what they've gone on to do since. They've gone on to take over Offaly hurling, and I don't say that lightly, and I stand behind it. They have taken over and they're the outstanding team in the county, and even this year, when by their own high standards they haven't maybe played as well as other years, they're still there and they're still in the final and they're still favourites to win it, and justifiably so. I think St. Rynaghs are a better team than they were in 2012, but I still think they're behind Kilcormac Leahy.
John Leahy, you're the resident KK man on the panel tonight, and Brian is putting pressure onto you there. You're now the team to catch, and no longer people are talking about KK being in the long grass in terms of championships. How is the expectation sitting on Kilcormac Leahy going into what would be a remarkable third in a row?
I think it's sitting well, Will. I think over the last 2 to 3 weeks, from what I hear from the camp, is that morale has picked up and there's confidence. They've heard a good challenge match since, so it's, you know, it's not usually Danny's trade in getting a good challenge match a week before a big game, and he hasn't changed from that, and they're going well. I suppose on the ground the supporters would be disappointed with them. Hurled poorly in a quarter final, hurled poorly in a semi final by their own standards, but yet there's great confidence within the club that they can do this. I would agree with Brian. There's no doubt about it. Rynaghs are a better team. I think Brian, the morale is good, the confidence is good. I think they're hurling with a lovely style. I don't think the weather is going to suit Rynaghs tomorrow. I think the underfoot conditions are going to suit Kilcormac Leahy because they're a bigger and physical side. But yes, both teams have improved since 2012. But I think Kilcormac Leahy have the edge with the experience. Going for three in a row, being in a Leinster final, being in an All-Ireland final. And, you know, they have a couple of key players there that I think Rynaghs is going to get hard to break down tomorrow.
Well, Joe Troy, John raised an interesting point about conditions. You know, coming up in less than 24 hours' time, that senior final is going to be on. There'll be a junior final on before it tomorrow. There was an intermediate final replay today. You walked the pitch when you were doing the interviews after the Shamrocks game this afternoon. What's the pitch like? Because I'm sure Rynaghs would have liked dry conditions this week.
Yeah, absolutely. Look, the sod is heavy, you know, underfoot, and it's caught up in parts, you know, due to the football today, a lot of twisting and turning. I won't say it's overly a mud batch yet, but you have a junior final tomorrow. There'll be heavy traffic between Clary and Ballymere. You know, both sets of subs worn up beforehand for both games. And if the forecast of rain goes ahead tonight, it would really suit Kilcormac. You look back in the semi-final, I know Kilcormac are, you know, a physical team, and a dogfight like that might suit them tomorrow if it came. But I was chatting to a very prominent Kilcormac Leahy man after the semi-final, and if you walked into O'Connor Park that day and just looked at the four teams as a man who knew nothing about hurling, and he had said, you know, who looked the best team today, and it was St. Rynaghs. You know, St. Rynaghs played a lovely brand of hurling. Franny Ford came in, done an excellent job coaching wise. They really stick to a style. They're playing lovely, you know, stick passes. They're carrying the ball through tackles. They're not, as opposed to Clarion the last day, Clarion drove balls long. Rynaghs mopped up. They carried it. A runner back, Steve Wynn, comes back up from centre forward. He carries ball out, sets up all the attack, the pinnacle of the team. And it's that kind of style that they're going to have to play to break down KK, because, you know, if Rynaghs start to lord balls, KK have the biggest backline in midfield in the county. You know, they'll break that back down and dominate. So Rynaghs will really have to be in full gear tomorrow.
Well, Brian Lowry, you raised the point at the outset and you said this is a St. Rynaghs team who are better than the Rynaghs model of 2012. What's better about them in 2014 than 2012?
Well, I think a lot of it has to go down to the manager. And, you know, Dinny Cal was over in 2012, nothing against Dinny and the panel he had with him, but getting someone like Francis Ford in was a massive thing for St. Rynaghs. You know, I talked to him during the week. He's a serious hurling man. He loves talking about hurling. He loves all thing about it. And, you know, it's hard to believe this is his first management job in hurling outside the school. It's his first ever club to take over. And he's gotten to a final in a county which is ultra competitive. The club scene in Offaly is competitive. Our county team might be going by the wayside, but our club scene is ultra competitive. And his coaching, he's renowned countrywide for his coaching. He's been a coach with Offaly before, a coach with Banner College, a manager at Banner College, won an All-Ireland with him. Well, it's his first actual management gig with a club. So, like, when you put that all into context and have him back in a final, I think he's been massively helped by the fact that he's coached. I think Ger Rafferty's the only one he hasn't coached through schools. And up to the school in Banner College, Gerry's been with him from first year to sixth year. He knows them inside out, and he even made a point last week to me that, you know, that to push Sean Dolan back fullback for the semi-final due to Gary Keneally's suspension. And a lot of people are like, God, you know, putting Sean Dolan back fullback, that's a massive gamble. He said he didn't even consider any gamble at all. because he played there in the schools, and even though it was so many years ago, he still knew he could do it. And that's the advantage of having someone like Francis there, the respect and the players have from Zouza now, talking to a couple of players, they're just, I think he's being a massive coup for them.
Well, John, you've been out to Colossian and the Shunna in Banner quite a bit with coaching and so on. What kind of coach is Francis for? Because I remember when they went on the All-Ireland journeys at vocational schools level, the players even then, you know, spoke about how important the good coaching was in the school.
Yeah, there's a Galway element to Franny in terms of the way they play, the move off the shoulder. People talk about the short game, but the short game that Franny plays is 40, 50 yards striking into the hand. It's something that, you know, it's not perfected with a lot of senior clubs in this county. I watched them in the quarter final against Belmont, watched them in the semi final against Clareen, and their pass on the ball was unbelievable. And their patience on the ball, I think, Will, is what he instills in them. To take the right option when the option comes about. Like, I've seen them recycling the ball 5-6 times and getting a score from it, not just aimlessly hitting it. They're a totally different style than Kilcormac Leahy. They'll just get it and they'll drive it into the forward line and they'll hope that Dan and the boys inside will do the business. But that's what he encourages. He encourages, and Joseph mentioned it there as well, Joe mentioned it in terms of what the half forward line do, and he mentioned Stephen Wynn. Paul Quirk will do the same. They'll come deep, but there's an element that complements Franny and his coaching style is the fact that a lot of them lads play football with Clohan, and it's a football style as well where they're coming off the shoulder, they'll wait till the right option is opened up, and then they'll knock the ball in. And Gerard Rafferty is a massive asset to them. They can change it. And the other thing that Franny Ford has done as well, Rynaghs are extremely fit. And you'll find tomorrow, every chance they'll get, they'll go and they'll run at you. I found with in the semi-final, they probably should have knocked on another 5 or 6 points against Clareen. For the simple reason is that they just kept running and they could have taken their shots, but they tried to create goal chances. So they have that confidence oozing out of them, that they just want to take the players on. Every time they get the ball, they'll be in the midfield or the half-forward line, full forward, they'll take the men on. And that's why I think the underfoot conditions is going to be a big factor tomorrow.
Well, Joe Troy, we've spoken there about Rynaghs in detail, KK this year, as John said initially. Maybe some people don't feel in Kilcormac and Clyde that they're playing quite at the level as years gone by. What's your assessment of KK so far in 2014?
Well, look, to me it's a results-based business. You know, people are probably looking at KK and they're maiden year in 2012. You know, they're hitting Dundasian Heights and they're playing an unbelievable brand of hurling. But to see them mature as a team, you know, it takes a team to grind out results. And you're thinking there's a lot miles on that KK clock. They're going nearly, you know, 36 months back-to-back. And, you know, people, I suppose, hurlers in the nature, people who, you know, don't analyse hurling the way that, you know, it's our job to do. But just say Keelan Kiley has come in. He's I think he's got 18 points or 19 points from playing this year's championship. He's been a huge asset to him. On the flip side then, you know, there's people who criticise Kieran Slevin. He hasn't done the scoring form that he's done in 2012 from play. But what I'd say to that is Kieran Slevin is probably still the linchpin to that team, because when it comes down to it, Kieran Slevin sacrifices his own game. He comes from wing forward, back nearly alongside Kevin Grogan and Brian Leonard, and off the back of the midfielder, and he carries up balls, delivers in quality ball, and you have James Gorman and Dan Corms inside who are reaping the benefits of that. You know, your players going deep, and that's the thing about KK. They don't really mind who gets the scores. Dan Corms was a go-to guy in terms of goals, but the last day when KK were suffering, the lads came back out to underwork. They left James Gorman inside, isolating him and Alan Corcoran. He had a distinct height advantage. Gorman got 4 points in play. KK win the match, and you know who's to care about the performance after that? They got the job done. They played to their strengths, and you know they're in a county final.
Well, Brian Lowry, that's an interesting point. James Gorman tomorrow, who's coming off the back of a couple of good performances, do you take the risk of putting him in close to the square, or do you play Kerms close to the goal?
Oh yeah, you play Dan Kerms full forward, there's no doubt about that, regardless of what kind of form anyone else is in. Dan Kerms is still the man in that full forward line. He's got six goals and 9 points this year. He's nearly more goals than he has points, so that tells his own tale. You know, he's there for a reason. If he gets half a sniff, whether it's in the first or the last minute, he'll go the head down for goals. He even said as much during the week to me. One thing I found with Kilcormac Leahy this year is their movement and the way they interchange, and it comes just effortlessly. There's no roaring and shouting. You go out here, you go out there. I saw that. I think it was one of the games up in Kennedy this year. Kieran Slevin came in off the wing. He had a big long mazy run. He ran through. He probably out of breath maybe after it, and without even any instruction, Dan Kerms just ran out the wing forward, and Kieran Slevin stayed in full forward for the next puck out, just to get his breath back. And like, that's just effortlessly. That comes from playing together. Like, you look down through that Kilcormac Leahy attack, and five of them at least, you know, Conor Mahon, Kieran Slevin, Dan Kerms, and James Gorman, say four. Them four have been there right since 2012, in their position, centre forward, full forward, wing, and corner. And they know what the other's going to do at any given time. And if the lad bursting through makes it a gut wrenching run, he's just left there. Then Conor Maher comes through, Curran's will come out, centre forward for 5 minutes. And it's a new problem then for a full-back or a centre-back. Mm. They can be preparing for Ryan's full-back and be preparing for Dan Corms, but for the 5 minutes that Conor Mahon is in there, it's totally different. Two balls could come in and it's totally different. It's just another aspect of the Kilcormac attack this year.
Well, John, that's something that could be interesting as well, because you know, Ryan's are happy enough oftentimes to bring their sweeper back in front of their defence. Usually he doesn't have someone to mark and everyone else can just pick up their players. But if KK play a fluid style and maybe start moving Mahon and Slevin and a few other lads around, it could make it more difficult for Rynaghs to play their normal style of defending.
That's right, and there's no doubt KK are going to do it, and Rynaghs will probably expect that to happen. It normally seems to happen in the second half when they need to change things around, and you know, Kieran will start drifting out wide, the midfielders will start sitting back deeper. But I think the big thing, the big switch that always happens is, and it works very, very well for Kilcormac Leahy, is Mahon goes back in the full forward, and Dan Corms comes out at centre forward. And it gives fierce options, because Dan likes the ball in, he'll win it nice and low, he'd like to take it on. Where Conor Mahon is, with 15 minutes to go, things are tiring. And when you have two midfielders sitting back deep, they're going to drive ball in. And Mahon is a great man. Conor Mahon's a great man to hold it up. And I think there's going to be a big game with Conor Mahon tomorrow. I'd say he'd be disappointed with his own standards that Joe Bergen held him the way he held him the last day. Mm. And nothing seemed to go right for him. So you'd imagine that change will happen. But you'd also have other options there. You've Keelan Kiley, can go to the middle of the field. He can go wing back. You know, you have the likes of Dylan Murray to come in there. You know, there's great options. Enda Grogan can come in there as well. There's any amount of options there. I think Kilcormac Leahy will play as selected. I think Rynaghs will try to counteract that. But the Kilcormac Leahy movement, I think, is well known at this stage. But it's still very hard to counteract, Will.
Well, Joe Troy, big man that Kilcormac Leahy have to get a handle on tomorrow, is Stephen Quirk, a guy who can score goals, a guy who's scored goals for the county this year. And you reckon you know what way they're going to defend against them?
Yeah, well, look, to me, you know, the obvious move is Joey O'Connor and Stephen Quirk are two corner forwards. You know, on matchups alone, you'd have to fancy Conor Mahon to pick up Joey O'Connor, two very, very pacey players, mm-hmm. both like to play from the front, particularly Conor Mahon, give an exhibition of defending from the front. Can be risky, but seems to have the belief in himself. He's able to get out there, get the ball, and be gone with it, and the forward can't catch him. I'd imagine he'd track Joey O'Connor, and to me, Alan McConville is probably one of the best, man markers in the county. You know, his size people might say it's a problem, but Alan is Tigerish, a very, very good defender, does his job there. You know, he's tied up Owen Ryan in years gone by. He's tied up Ross King from Rathdown Air in the Leinster Club Championship. You know, he's tied up Owen Ryan again the last he was taken off. Tied up Brian Carroll before. So, like, you know, a man that does his job unassuming, and people say, right, we'll target Alan McConville. He hasn't hide. Alan McConville probably one of the most Tigerish defenders in the county. And I think that's the way they line out. But so we've been talked a good lot about Kilcormac Leahy. It's what Ryan has bring to the game and get their matchups right. Ryan is probably one of the best backlines and the most organised and disciplined backlines in the county. Like Dermot Short, you know, in an era where often you're struggling for big men on county teams, Dermot Short is a big man, but he can hurl as well. I see him in Rath in one of the group games. He came out with ball after ball, and his distribution is excellent. Rynaghs aren't coming out with traditional full-back or centre-back, getting the ball and driving it along. As John said, they're coming out 30, 40 yards from goals. Their wing forwards are coming attacking ball, and straight into the hand. You throw in Simon O'Glynn's, Pat Cameron, Danny Maloney, in fairness to Danny Maloney, he's kept off Niall Wynn, who's the Offaly County cornerback, mm-hmm. off the team, injury or no injury. Danny Maloney's had a fine year. That's a very, very good Rynaghs backline. And how they get their matchups right, I'd imagine Gary Keneally, after a suspension, will come back, start centre half back. Dermot Short will probably drop back. Sean Dolan, I'd imagine, will go to midfield, maybe at the expense of Aidan Tracy or someone like that. And then they're going to look at Danny Maloney in there, Tigerish and James Gorman. They're going to look at Gary Keneally physically match Conor Mahon. And that's how Rynaghs, tie up them, because we've talked a lot about Kilcormac and Kilcormac's strengths, but Rynaghs can really throw a spanner into the works tomorrow. They play that lovely brand of hurling. If they stick to that, if they don't start, the far away from their plan and coming down and playing Kilcormac Leahy's game, if they stay dragging people out, getting the scores, isolating the boys inside, and just say Stephen Quirk or Joey O'Connor are getting a better read of the cornerbacks, Rynaghs get a goal there, it could be a serious upset on the cards.
Well, a lot of those Rynaghs players have won minors and they've been into 21s finals in recent years, but 20 plus years is a long time to wait to win a senior final. Brian Lowry, I'll do a final run around to get predictions for tomorrow. Can Rynaghs bridge that gap, or are we talking KK 3 in a row?
No, I think Rynaghs can. I think definitely to have the hurlers. I think they've been the best team so far in the championship this year, and that goes without a shadow of a doubt. I think probably Kilcormac Leahy's biggest weakness is the fact that everyone knows how they're going to play. Mm. Everyone knows what they're going to get with Kilcormac Leahy. There'll be no messing on the team sheet. 1-15 will play. They'll play 1-15, which is something that's very rare these days. So while that might be a weakness, it's still a different story trying to stop it. And I think. I don't think Rynaghs will stop it tomorrow, but I think it'll be far from a one-sided affair. Regardless of what the weather is like, I think Rynaghs are are tuned in. I think Francis Ford will have them ready, and it'll take a monumentous effort to get three in a row from this Kilcormac team, but I think it will.
I suppose, look, if you line out one way and play one way, it means you know plan A very, very well, and obviously it's worked so far. John Leahy, for you tomorrow?
Yeah, it comes down to three things, Will, really. I think experience. You look over the last couple of years there, Kilcormac Leahy, I think, have the edge on the experience. It comes down to the key battles. I think Kilcormac Leahy still have enough to get through that, and I suppose the style of that they're being played tomorrow, I actually love, and I love endorsing the type of style that Franny Ford is putting into Rynaghs. It's a very team game, but I think the weather is going to go against them on that footing. I think it's going to suit Kilcormac, a big physical side, and I can see Kilcormac Leahy edging it out.
Well, that's two votes for KK. Joe Troy, what were you going to go? Is this going to be a full house?
Yeah, well, it probably will be a full house, but I suppose I'd say Rynaghs are probably in the same boat as Kilcormac Leahy were 3 or 4 years ago. They have a young team, a lovely style, a fair team. They're definitely the second best, if they don't prove to be the best team tomorrow in the county. You know, only Gerafri to me would be over the age of 30. A young team, you know, and play a lovely style. And I think Rynaghs today might be tomorrow, but it will come soon. But I just, Ollie Canning used to say about Portumna, if any team come in one, you know, it takes a very good team to do back to back. But to be a great team, you need to win your three in a row. And I think Kilcormac Leahy, you listen to the Healians, the sound bites coming out of them, you listen to Conor Mann, you listen to the lads in the interviews. They know the three in a row is a huge thing, and they know they have to make hay while the sun shines there in Kilcormac Leahy. I think Rynaghs will have their day, make no doubt about it. And if Rynaghs turn up with a win tomorrow, I wouldn't be one bit surprised. That's not writing off Rynaghs, but I think Kilcormac Leahy's day of destiny is tomorrow, and I think they will just prove too strong in the end.